Alright, now it's time to go through Brightstone Cove, Tesseldora. We did the congregation a few episodes ago. Let's try to get through here. So, the big change they made in this version is that there's way more spiders than there used to be, but they're also pretty goddamn afraid of fire. So if you keep a torch lit, you're usually safe. One of my obvious concerns is going to be whether or not I'm going to get invaded. I did make sure to nullify the human effigy effect. There's a platform down there. This is one of the more confusing locations to explore, I think, in this game. Because there's just so many goddamn platforms everywhere that I don't know how anyone keeps track of where all these places go. Petrified Dragon Bone! I can now... Let's see, these guys shouldn't be here. Yeah. I didn't really do these guys' story this time around, so Creighton and Pate are not here. But it doesn't really matter. Because I already have the item you get from helping them. At this point, it only comes down to, like, do I want special equipment from them? Like, you can get their equipment, I guess, but even then... actually, no, you get access to both of them the first time around, because the one you kill, you can just buy from the hag. For a second there, I thought that one was still alive. Is this openable? Nope. Yep, still don't know this map very well. I did not take this path last time, though. I'm very happy to have found that, you son of a bitch. Now, you son of a bitch! Spellcaster's here. Move. Inside. There we go. Ooh, an Estus Flask Shard. That's probably the one I missed out of the entire last playthrough. I think that's the only one I didn't get. Go figure. They're hidden everywhere. Another Petrified Dragon Bone. Alright. So now, if I die for any reason at this point, I'm probably just gonna go back to town. Because then I can get that upgrade. Does not open from the side. Yeah, you have to drop down from above to get access to that particular room. Which is rough, because that's where the local bonfire is. Not the door! Bowman Guthrie! That's not a player? Was he here? Did the Bowman attack me last time? I don't remember him. He feels new. Hey buddy, what you doing? Oh, you fighting some spiders? Oh god, here he comes. Here he comes. Hey buddy, how you doing? I'ma hit you really hard in the face! Wow, I'm really surprised that, like, none of those attacks hit him somehow. That was weird. There we go. Yeah, that's right. Resist this. We got a giant hammer. I think I do remember being invaded by him, actually. I think I ran into the next room when he invaded. Anyway, this is where we normally would fight Ornifex. And I need to do some off-camera catching up there to gain access to her, because I'll need her to trade in boss souls. Haven't done that yet, but also probably not going to show it, because we did that last time anyway. I always have to remind myself, if I don't find the key naturally, I always have to remind myself where the hell the key is, too. That's fine. That's something I'll take care of. Hello, surprise summoning sign. I feel like I should light these, but I don't know if it's really worthwhile. I don't know if there's a reason to light those torches or not. I think it's just... they're just kind of around. I think they're new. I don't remember there being sconces everywhere in this level the first time through. Get out of here. Trying to petrify me and shit. Hoot! Homing attacks, why? Hit. It does feel nice to light things up, though, for sure. Get out of here. Fall off this level. Is there anything back here? Probably not. At the very least, I suppose the sconces will just make local safe areas where the spiders don't like to hang out. Let's summon Bashful for funsies. Someone was complaining I don't summon enough people. And then, of course, people always complain when you do summon people. Basically, the Dark Souls audience is the most fickle, nonsensical, and, the audience that speaks for everyone while also simultaneously not speaking for... Oh god, I just made a mistake. He's not gonna attack me. A lot of people that watch Dark Souls videos like to say, everyone can only make videos this way. And then, of course, there's 100 dissenting opinions, so it's like, well, it looks like you weren't speaking for anyone. See how that goes. See, it's gonna be nice getting the weapon upgraded with that fifth Petrified Dragon Bone, because that means we're gonna have a damage boost when it's time to fight the Lost Sinner. Which could help, mollify problems led by me having a reduced mobility by using this big awkward weapon. But yeah, I definitely want to have... I definitely would like to have my weapon fully upgraded by the time I go walking into the likes of Drang Lake Castle, especially because of the certain New Game Plus exclusive fight that we're going to have to do. And the DLCs, of course. It's funny, if I remember correctly, I maximum upgraded my... Owie! Why? Why must you do that, wandering swordsman? I used to be you. I started this playthrough as you. Uh-oh. Chugging time. Uh-oh. Everyone take that damage. Yes. Everyone take the spike damage. Enjoy it. Embrace it. That was rude, sir. I'm gonna have to deal with you now. Oh, I'm out of stamina. That's a bummer. Everyone's just taking the tiniest bits of chip damage, making just the dumbest noise. Oh, rude. You'll get your turn minor, dude. I don't care about you. I'm dealing with actual threats here. That's an annoying sound. Titanite! So much Titanite. Anything else around here? Look at him flinching. Get some poise, Bashful, you silly man. Alright. Any other surprise loot around here? Wow, that was the lucky box. Hey, spider. You're making me creepy. Don't walk up on me like that. Did I just say you're making me creepy? That doesn't even make sense. Or does it? Can I drop down there? I shouldn't, obviously. I mean, I'll die. I was just wondering. I wasn't sure if that was like a weird unprotected ledge or not. That should drop directly into the boss fight chamber, I believe. I might just summon things for funsies in this part. Fucking Freya is the most boring boss fight out of the four, where it's just like, all you do is walk in. Hello, Manhunter. You just walk in there and you just hit it in the face over and over again while attacks that aren't even particularly aimed at you get just sort of spread out. So here, for the person that said I don't summon enough, here's your summoning episode. This is not exactly a skillful fight that I'm missing out on, since it's just... Yeah, Freya's just boring. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. I love it when someone gets in your way on the way to a door and your character just sort of shimmies around like, huh? I guess this is my life now. Oops. Power attack? There we go. We're in awkward and closed spaces. There we go. So what I was getting at before I got interrupted by that invader dude. If I remember correctly, I maximum upgraded my... Yeah, I did. So I have a maximum upgraded Dragon Greatsword and Curved Nil Greatsword and Chariot Lance. That's the thing about Dark Souls games, is that move sets are so all over the place that it's like, okay, cool, that one has good stats. And then you upgrade the weapon, you're like, oh, well, it had good stats, but I hate this weapon. Like, when you start using it. So then you're like, so suddenly you find yourself wanting completely different moves, and unfortunately you can't get those upgrade items back, so you just end up with a bunch of plus 5 and plus 10 weapons that you maybe don't use anymore, because you're not super satisfied with their results. Is that shimmery... It's all shimmery looking. We have a forlorn. Where is he spawning at? He's up. He's in for a surprise. I got a naked person and a bashful person here to help me. Oh, wait, no, she's wearing clothes. It was just hard to tell. Hey, forlorn. I've got a lance. I mean, I'm not a big fan of these, so we'll see how you like it. Hey, buddy. Fun times. Uh-oh. Not as much of a dead-on hit as I was hoping for. There we go. That was more of a stagger.
Hey, buddy.
Yep. And charge! That's fantastic. Got the full combo on that one. Did Bashful Ray just throw... Oh, he has a dodge teleport. He's using the Simpleton's Ring, I think it's called. Or whatever it's... Or something like that. There we go. You silly forlorn. Realistically, all of these spider webs should be very flammable. So I should actually be in way more trouble for even walking around here with this, fire. I should probably just, like... There should be a debuff that makes you covered in web. Like, it's a web state. Which I believe actually does exist. I think enemies can web you in this game. Or is that Bloodborne? Or is that Witcher? I don't know. I played a game... One of the games I've played recently has a web debuff. And that web debuff should make you move slowly. And then if you're holding a torch, it should work like the oil effect on a Bloodborne, where it lights you on fire. That would lead an interest that'll lead to an interesting risk-reward system with the, with all of these, spider environments. Like, oh yeah, light a torch. It'll make it, it'll make you less likely to be attacked by the invaders. Also, you're going to die horribly if you touch a web. Let's see if I can find the summon that's around. There it is. There we go, guys. I'm showing you the cool new feature that's in Scarlet of the First Sin, which is that you can have three summons now. They expanded multiplayer. I believe they added one more slot for invaders and one more slot for summons. So now let's just turn into a four-player match. We have Ash Knight Boyd, Manhunter O'Hara, Bashful Ray. Now it's time to do a boss fight. I might just watch them do it. It might be kind of fun just to watch the, sort of spectate while the NPCs fight the boss. Howdy, y'all. I'll just let you guys have your little bit of fun as all three of them. Oh, that was a cool dramatic little scene. It was overshadowed by their giant health bars, but you could see them going through. Oops. You could see them going through the wall as one big crowd, which is kind of neat. Let's see. I'll just replace my weapon with that shield. There we go. Now I can just watch as these NPCs try to do a boss fight. You guys can do it, I believe in you. Oh wow, it's already a third dead. I didn't even notice that he had taken damage already. Oh wait, he took damage because I fought him upstairs. Right. Forgot about that new game plus quirk. Yeah, with a torch and a shield, I should be invulnerable to damage for the most part. This has 100% block. 100% physical block at least, and my torches will last 4.5 hours, so we won't get attacked by any spiders in the environment. So Boyd and Bashful Ray are very aggressive right in the face. Taking a lot of damage, they're not making great progress so far. O'Hara probably has the best luck because they're attacking at range. And it knows it's smart enough to attack the face. Because it's using a... They use lock-on fighting, so the fact that the O'Hara uses a bow in the first place means he's set. Oh! Was that Ashen Knight Boyd, or was that Faithful Bashful Ray? One of them's using Oh yeah, it's Bashful Ray has pyromancies. This is the first time I've seen him use pyromancies before. That's new. Well, this is a cool little scene. Yeah, I think they're gonna get him. They're not. They had a bad start where they're taking a lot of hits, but now they're doing all right. Oh, I got webbed. But I was blocking, so it's fine. This is a cool little drama scene. Alright, I don't know why it's a drama scene. There's something epic about watching three things fight a giant thing. It's too bad I can't compare numbers or something to see who's doing the most damage. I remember Ashen Knight Boyd being pretty effective when I used him the very, very first time I played the game. It looks like he just... Yep. Ray and Boyd both just used Estus Flasks. So that, yeah, if they're smart enough to heal, then they've definitely got this. Some AI just won't heal, and they'll just hang out and die. You definitely get an idea of how big their health pools are when they heal. Because they use Nestus Flask, and you just watch them super slowly regenerate a tiny chunk of their health. Oh, lasers. Let's get over here. Nope. Oh! And Boyd is... Oh, both of the melee characters went down. That laser is by far the most dangerous thing this thing can do. Uh-oh. Welp, I walked into that. My bad. I guess I have to fulfill being in melee range, or it's just gonna sit there and keep doing lasers. Come on, O'Hara, you can do it. I believe in you, maybe, or something. I don't know. Someone's gotta believe in you. Oh, laser. It's in laser mode. O'Hara, are you even fighting now? Oh, you're fighting that thing. Well, this is tragic. What if I hit with my shield? Shield kill. Oh, Gotta hit that face correctly, though. Whoop, watch out. Pincer attack. Shield bam. Oh, come on. Get in my shield. Uh-oh. That was rude. That hurt. I don't really appreciate your behavior, sir. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Dodge. Shield slam. Yeah. Uh-oh. So this is my all-new and zero-weapon run of Deer's Duke Freya. I hope you appreciate it. Ow. Rude. No. Do not want. There we go. I don't know why I'm not just flasking. The fight's almost over. I'm being stupid. Uh-oh. Holy crap, that was rude. Slam! Come on and slam! Uh-oh. I missed. Don't die here. That would be so dumb. This is a dumb fight. Hello. Alright, you're dead now. Death by shield. Right-handed shield, too. Hey, little spider. Alright, well, O'Hara made it. Both of the melee characters got wiped out by lasers. They probably took, like, roughly the first half of their health in the first laser and the second half in the second laser. And then it started laser spamming, so they were definitely going to be dead sooner or later at that point. No invasions happened, except for the multiple NPCs that are scripted. So we had the wandering swordsman invader. We had the archer invader, the dual Avalon's invader, and we had. Hey, buddy, come on, it's friendly. There we go. We had dual Avalon's invader. We had archer invader, and we had what's it called? I'm forgetting right now. Oh, what's that? Oh, that's this. Never mind. That's just how I get into the memory. I thought that was a dragon. I thought a dragon covenant guy somehow put a summoning sign here. I'm like, all right, that'd be a fun place to fight a dragon. All right, in we go. Someone made a recent video that pointed out something kind of interesting to me, which is that I'll have to deal with this guy real quick, though. Hey, buddy. I wish I could backstab with the shield, but backstabs are R1, and R1 is block with this weapon. Haha, shield combo. Fragrant Branch of Yore. I need that to get to Ornifex, I think, so that's handy. There we go. This device right here on the table. Where is it? I believe it's this. Which one is it? Oh, there it is. This device is actually the same device. It's hard to see because it's zoomed out. But the device on this table is the same navigation object you find on the ship right after the Flexile Sentry. Not much else going on in here. I don't think. Mainly that fragrant branch. Oh yeah, and they moved the invader, so he's not here either. Because they moved Ven Garl's body elsewhere. Chugging for no reason. Alright, let's go level up my weapon that I just proved I don't need because I didn't even use it. Ta-da! 3 out of 4 lit. A primal bonfire was rekindled. Now get out of here and don't come back. There ain't no DLC door here. It does feel like a slight missed opportunity. The game has four Primal Bonfires, but 3 DLCs, and only two of the DLCs are right after Primal Bonfires. The last one's at the Shrine of Winter instead, and there's just a weird lack of, like, using all 4 Primal Bonfires. Anyway, someone wants me to get the Crypt Greatsword, but I'm just now upgrading this one. I don't know, we'll see if I get enough Petrified Dragonbone to be able to upgrade that one too. I guess I'm up to having one more again, so that's handy.
Demon's Great Hammer.
I don't know. Having a Great Hammer could be fun. He uses Twinkling Titanite instead, so that might be worth looking into. Anyway, this is now at 430 plus 213 damage, mainly because of its S scaling with strength, making it, I want to say, my most powerful weapon. I'll compare it to Curved Greatsword and Chariot Lance at plus 5. The Curved Nil Greatsword does, it's Dark Enchanted right now, so it does 182 plus 223, which is about 400 damage, plus 85 plus 45, making it 130, so 530 about. This thing does 430 plus 213, which is about 440, 640. So it does about 110 more damage than the Curved Nil Greatsword does. And it's bigger, and it has a more useful moveset, honestly. This thing has a nice consistent strike, I guess. I'm pretty sure it has a smaller hitbox because the blade is clearly smaller. It looks freaking awesome, though. And it has that cool scimitar attack, because that's what it basically is. This is it's called a curved nail greatsword. It's basically a greatsword with a scimitar moveset. Then we have the chariot lance. So we've got our dumb little collection of strength weapons that can be really punishing to invaders and stuff like that. I definitely think that fighting NPC invaders in particular is just way easier with big heavy weapons that stagger them. And that really fast overhead swing combo, mainly the part where it does an immediate follow-up, is really handy. Because if you do multiple swings at NPCs and players, they tend to dodge out of the way after like the first hit. So being able to just be like, hut, yep, just immediately follow up with the second strike as it comes out of the ground, usually means I'm more likely to hit someone as far as I can tell. Anyway, boss soul. Soul of the Duke's Dear Freya, the Writhing Ruins Keeper. The Writhing Ruin is an ancient thing whose shadow remains cast over the land. It first took possession of a solitary insect, but grew its power, feasting on the wealth of twisted souls found in the land. And then the old Pale Drake soul, Soul of the Ineffable. This once magnificent soul continues to exert influence over the land, even after the eons have reduced it to these remnants. Yeah, aside from vaguely hinting at Lord Vessel bosses, you really don't get a lot of story or anything out of those four bosses. The bonus boss souls. Oh, I have enough to level twice. It's a lot of experience to get. Probably just keep going into endurance to keep increasing my stamina meter. It's hard to say. I'm definitely tempted just to sit there and just pour points constantly into my vitality, into my health, until it's like, you have maximum health now. Because being able to just soak up blows is the best thing you can do for staying alive, as far as I can tell.